So the first equation, it says find the roots of the equation without actually solving it. So I repeat, to find the nature of the roots, we only get the discriminant, that is the value of b square minus 4ac. So a is 4, b is 16, c is 15, the discriminant is b square minus 4ac. So that is 16 square minus 4 into 4 into 15. So solving, we get the answer as 16 greater than 0. Now I said, if it is greater than 0, go one step further. So is 16 a perfect square? Well, that 16 is 4 square. So this is a perfect square. So the roots are perfect square, so rational. And of course, different. So roots are rational and different. Now, one thing in mind, you have to write both the characteristics, real, imaginary, or complex, okay, real and equal. Not only one characteristics, you have to write both the characteristics. So rational and different, both. Okay, I come to the next sum. So the discriminant is 0. So if the discriminant is 0, the roots are real and equal. So what you have to do actually is just find the discriminant, look at the value, write the nature. Okay, I come to the third one. So this is it. Now one error which normally the students we find do, square of a negative number, minus 6 whole square, many children write is that's minus 36. It's not that you don't know it, but it's an error which you commit in the exam. Keep in mind that even power of a negative number is always positive. I repeat, even power of a negative number is always positive, which you have done earlier. So if the power is 2, 4, 6, 8 like that, it will always be positive. So don't make a mistake, which the children do. So here the discriminant is 12, positive, but not a perfect square. So here the roots will be real and distinct. Now you have an option here in the next question. Either simplify it and get into the form of quadratic equation by removing the denominator, but it is already in the form of a quadratic equation. It's of the form ax square plus bx plus c. So you need not simplify it. If you wish to do it, you can. Here I do directly a is 7 by 8, b is minus 1. C is 2 by 7, the discriminant is b square minus 4ac, that is 1 minus 4 into 7 by 8 into 2 by 7, so that is 1 minus 1 is 0 again, so the roots are real and equal. So these are the four sums where I found the nature of the roots without solving. Okay, you can do that. I come to a little application of it. It says find the value of k if the equation has equal roots. Well, an equation is given, make sure it is in the form of a quadratic equation. Well, it's not, so start with the equation. So this is in the form of quadratic equation. A is k, well, mind, A is the coefficient of x square. So x square, the coefficient is k. B, coefficient of x minus 2k, and C is equal to 6. The question says the roots are equal. Since the roots are equal, the discriminant is 0. That implies b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now pay attention here. In this question, it's already said that the roots are equal. You have to find something unknown. So when it says roots are equal, you start with b square minus 4ac must be equated to 0. If it says the roots are real, b square minus 4ac greater than 0. Okay, if the roots are imaginary or complex, b square minus 4ac is negative. So this equal to 0, equal to positive, greater than 0, less than 0 has to be mentioned in the sum. Okay, and then substitute the value b square, that is minus 2k whole square minus 4ac, a is this is equal to 0. So is this all right? Now look at this. Well, this is not correct. You are missing something. We got a quadratic equation in K. I told you while doing, whenever you get a quadratic equation, you will have two solutions. You must put importance to both the solutions. So here, if I write only K equal to 6, we are missing something. We have taken only one value. So other value will be here, 0. Product of two numbers is 0. So either 4K equal to 0, that is K equal to 0 by 4 is 0, or K minus 6 is 0, so K is equal to 6. So be very careful wherever you get a quadratic equation, answer will be two answers and you have to write both answers. Otherwise, everything you have done correct here, just leaving this, you will lose marks. So keep that in mind. I do just one more sum, taking a little bigger equation.